Hello, happy site owners. Man, here with the BlogAid Today Tip. Actually, I just want to check in with you and see if everybody's doing okay with their WordPress 4.8.2 update. This was a minor release in that we went from 4.8.1 to 4.8.2, meaning that it automatically updated for most of us, unless, of course, you have things like that turned off. Now, what wasn't minor about it were all the security patches that were released. There were tons of, well, not tons, but about 9 cross-site scripting vulnerabilities, XSS. And this is the most common issue with plugins and themes and all kinds of stuff. They update for this kind of thing all the time. And the reason it's all the time is because of the code. You know, the hackers find a new way to exploit it and put this particular kind of security issue in there. So they have to go rearrange a little bit of code sometimes. So some of your plugins, even when you update those, they fix this little vulnerability several times. It could be several times a year that this happens because hackers never sleep. You know, they're always looking for ways to exploit something. And they found a few in WordPress this time. So they're all patched. That's the nice thing about it. All you have to do is update. And for many of us, that rolls right through, you know, automatically for us. Now, I haven't heard of any widespread issues anybody is having with this. Most people have been checking their sites today. It actually rolled out last night. And I was actually in the middle of doing a training session. I was teaching some folks how to maintain their sites when this thing was rolling through, and it was going all kinds of goofy because it was in the process of actually auto-updating. You know, show me a notice that there was an update, but it started the auto-update for me right in the middle of that training. Things went kind of goofy. It's like, I don't think we're going to be updating plugins right in the middle of this. It was kind of funny. But they got to see that in an auto-update. I think that's the first time I've ever caught one going around live, too, when it was actually doing the update. So I've received notification from my WordPress sites that they've been updated. Now, some hosts have gotten into being middlemen between these updates. SiteGround is one of them. I've noticed in site audits, they've added code to not allow auto updates, and that code was put there by SiteGround. And so they want to decide when people upgrade, I guess. You know, I can understand their position on this because they have tens of thousands, maybe hundreds of thousands of site owners, WordPress site owners on their hosting that are not doing any updates of any kind. And so they've kind of taken that over because lack of updates is the number one ways that hackers get into a site. When they do that, they put the whole server at risk and it's a mess for everybody, right? And this is part of the host protecting themselves mainly under the guise of helping you out. But I'm going to be checking into that. You know, I've got a test account over there. My main sites are on A2 hosting, but I've got test accounts over on SiteGround, and I'm going to dig into that to see how to bypass it or where that's coming from or if it's being issued for all sites, because I've got a lot of site owners that said, no, man, I never turned that on. I never opted into that. So it may be something that they're deciding to do, and that's great, except for one thing. What if a major release comes out, like we just went through it, like WordPress 4.8, most of us didn't upgrade to that. We stuck at WordPress 4.7.9 and then jumped to WordPress 4.8.1 because we wanted to get around that text editor issue. So are they going to fix our sites when they break, when something like that happens? Are they taking responsibility for that? And so it should be something that you should be able to opt in or out, because, you know, my site owners who are educated and whatever, they want to take care of their own and make their own decisions about that. So it is something that I'm going to be checking into. If you know of other hosts that do similar things where they're playing kind of the man in the middle sort of thing about when you get updates and that sort of thing, and you're not on managed hosting, it's not an extra thing that you paid for, please do let me know, because I like to track this down and find out where these settings are and tell people about them in those other hosts. And it takes a village to learn about stuff like that. So that's all the news there is today. Thankfully, it's a slow news day otherwise, but if you're having any issues with the new WordPress rollout or anything, please do let me know. Leave a comment here for it, and I'll see you online.